A weakling weighing 98 pounds will get sand in his face when kicked to the ground. And soon in the gym, with a determined chin, the sweat from his pores as he works for his cause will make him glisten and gleam. And with massage and just a little bit of steam, he'll be pink and quite clean. He'll be a strong man. Oh, honey, but the wrong man. He'll eat nutritious, high protein, and swallow raw eggs. Try to build up his shoulders, his chest, arms, and legs. Such an effort, if he only knew of my plan. In just 7 days, I can make you a man. He'll do press-ups and chin-ups, do the smirch, clean and jerk. He thinks dynamic tension must be hard work. Such strenuous living, I just don't understand. When in just 7 days, oh baby, I can make you a man.
Excuse me, Mr. Yeah, you with the beard.
You don't appear. I had enough of you already.
Oh, no one has enough of me. Hey, where are you going?
What the hell are you doing in here now?
I've heard some, top secret, knowledge that you have,
Mr. Perry, I want you out.
No. I promise I'll be good this time.
Look, the first time you came here, okay, I was working on the chemical safety video you wanted to do, and also a nuclear reactor. You took it upon yourself to shut off my coolant system. And blew up the whole...
A mistake anyone could have made.
Yeah, right.
A young
and
reporter.
Of course, after that,
it was my first story, okay?
Yeah, well, okay. That
thanks to you,
good.
I lost my job at ATV.
I worked for you lost
Community Cable.
What?
I have to work for Community Cable.
I don't do interviews for Community Cable. Now look, the first time you were in here, you blew up my lab. We weren't in that underground room. We'd both be dead now. You blew up 5 miles of stuff. Radioactivity that's going to last 1,000 years, and then... Okay, next time you came here, I was doing this starship, remember? And you decided to turn on the engines, and we took off. I remember that. I remember it very well, Mr. Perry. In there, you wrecked the auxiliary control room. It's going to take me another year to finish that auxiliary control room again. And you think I'm going to let you back in the lab again? I am now in the process of another very delicate experiment, and you are going...
Yes, I've learned some information about that. You're, in the creation of some sort of superhuman bionic capabilities.
Bionic man, yes. And I don't want you going down there to see him because you'll wreck him. I know you. You're going to find something and say, what's this switch for? Boom, you're going to blow something up like last time.
I wouldn't do that.
Yeah, you did it twice. I would have been an excuse if it had been your first story, but you did it on your second story.
Well, this is my last chance. You gotta help me.
Yeah, you bet it's your last chance. Not with me, it's not gonna be. You're gonna have to do some real convincing. Okay, I'll put my book away. Might as well. Yeah, from College of Cape Breton Library. Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Very funny. Scott Adams, I think. Scott Adams, what was his name? Douglas Adams, that was it. Anyway, you gotta read, that's funny. But anyway, suppose you want to go up to the computer. This is a bit of a long trek. All right. Just
gonna
shut the door here. Now!
Nice ship.
Pardon? Oh, yeah, the mural on the wall, yeah. Anyway, I'll tell you what I brought you up here for. I'm not coming up here to show off the decor. Actually, to create this bionic man, right, I need a supercomputer here to, control most of the basic diagnostic functions and so on. As you can see, it says on here, Victor von Schlitzenmeier supercomputer operating system version 1.0. 640 terabyte random access memory, 417,810,056,389,583 bytes free. That's how much memory is presently free. That's not all of it, by the way. That's about half of it. And the other half takes up the computer's operating system. Anyway, my, I can't go on babbling like this. Forget it. So anyway, basically what I want to do here is I'm going to access the computer with my access code, which changes every day, so even if you get a shot of it, it's not going to do you any good. So, that's it. Right. Now if I enter a wrong access code, right, like say if I go like that, right, it'll tell me, incorrect logon code, abort retry. So you can't get into this computer unless you know the code, and it also does an automatic retina scan. Anyway, all right, abort, right. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the correct logon, get access, and I'm gonna go to the main menu. The computer understands plain English commands. It's got artificial intelligence.
Of course.
All right, there's the main menu of all the different things. Some of this has to do with the spaceship that, you see, the environmental systems command system. All that stuff.
Of course.
I'm still working on it, Mr. Perry, and I hope I'll get it working someday. In the meantime, the bionics experiment is what we're dealing with, the bionic man. So that's option 17. And there's the bionics experiment submenu. Now, what we're basically going to do now, I want to test. The bionic man is downstairs, hooked to the equipment now. So I want to run a test on all of his final power-up checklist. I was going to power him up in a little while after... I was going to wait till later on today because I want some time to relax, but you're obviously not going to give that to me, so I'm going to just go for final pre-power checkup now. Let's see, biofunction monitor, central nervous system, neural activity, right, mitochondrial activity, all systems nominal, good. All right then, see this is just basically a checklist of all the basic systems. There's a few, like the Bionic Man is partially biological, partially robotic. He's got human muscles that are, reinforced by mechanical contrivances and so on to increase their strength by about 10 times over. Also, he has a positronic brain as opposed to a normal biological brain. As opposed to a normal biological brain, and he also has his own diagnostic system. It tells him whenever there's a malfunction in any of the biological or computer systems. And he's got all kinds of different things. He's got a math sub-processor, he's got all kinds of things. Anyway, I'm gonna go back to the main menu, and now what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put it in a continuous loop level 4 diagnostic. And I'm going to leave the computer running, doing that diagnostic, and because the computer has to keep checking all of his systems before I power him up. Now I'm gonna take you down to the lab after this.
Oh, good.
Remember your promise, Mr. Perry. You don't touch one blessed thing, not one button, right? Anyway, go into the continuous loop level diagnostic, and basically it's just the same list as you saw before, only this time it's running a diagnostic. This thing's quite noisy. And basically just running a diagnostic of all the different things. Yeah, the
things. Of course.
Each of these numbers has a different meaning. It's too long to explain. So, that's it for the lab then. It's just a coverall. All my clothes are underneath. The jeans I was wearing, the shirt. This is something to cover up so I don't wreck my jeans and my shirt. It's like, I can't get it. The zipper won't. Here we go. Let's see. I've got to make an adjustment on a panel over here. Just a minute. The man is already done. Oh, right here. Pull out through here. I don't want you to hurt yourself here.
Where's that switch there?
He's down here. Basically, the first thing I've got to do is load his personality. You know, it's going to take me a few minutes of setting up. It's okay. Not going to hurt you any.
I'll just wait.
Well, keep your camera rolling.
Of course.
All right. My new bionic man is right in there.
I don't see anything.
Of course not. The light's not on yet. Here's right over there. Wait, where the heck is that plug? There it is. Let's plug in the light right there. There he is. What do you think?
He looks dead.
Of course he looks dead, Mr. Perry. I haven't turned him on yet.
Oh, right. I see.
I know that didn't sound right, but anyway.
Yeah.
Look.
What's the switch here, dude?
Don't touch any. That's a light switch. Oh. Do not touch any more switches. Oh. This switch is disabled. You're not going to be messing that up on me again. No way. Right? See? And you're not coming in here. I'm with all the switches that are in my reach, not in your reach. Now you're going to promise me not to touch the switches again, right?
Uh-huh.
Right.
Right.
Now, let's start by powering up all the systems here. It's too much explanation to explain everything. But this here is the supercomputer right here. Now you would never think.
I thought that was upstairs.
No, the supercomputer itself is down here. Upstairs is the terminal for access to the supercomputer.
Ah.
This is the computer itself. It's very small. A computer, a supercomputer size, with these superconducting chips, which I invented, by the way.
Of course.
Would have power that's totally unimaginable. I can't wait. I'm going to be a rich man. These superconducting chips, the one the size of a pin, the head of a pin, can do 10,000 times as much as today's microchips can do at that size. So they're real cool chips. Anyway, we're going to power this up. Start with this system. Okay, this is just basically all these different monitoring systems and power systems and so on. This is a power distribution node. All right. And then this one here. This here. I'll wait for this to warm up.
What the hell is that?
All right. Well, the different systems are for different types of monitoring. This is basically the same thing it was before. This is more or less a monitoring panel with intercom switches. This is a power distribution panel. This is a... it was the diagnostic systems panel. This is part of the diagnostic system panel.
Of course.
All this is the diagnostic system panel.
Of course.
This is the power generator. I don't need a nuclear reactor this time, since I don't trust nuclear reactors with you around, and I figured you might be around. Because I knew every time I try an experiment, you're always right there in my way. Alright. Now, basically, I want to run the final diagnostic on it first. This little micro board here is the diagnostics board. You're probably getting a zoom on that now. Board number 1918. So, I'm just going to put this over here. And we plug the diagnostics board into the back of the supercomputer like so.
Hey, what's that? What's this thing on the wall here? The red thing.
What red thing? Oh, this. That's part of the supercomputer control panel. All right. I just got to turn on the supercomputer first. All right. Then we install the board. Now I'm going to run some diagnostics tests on the positronic brain to make sure it's working properly before I try to power them up. Now first I'm going to power up the panel. There we go.
Do you have any idea what you're doing?
Everything. I know exactly what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
What makes you think I don't? I haven't blown up anything. You're the one that blows up things, not me.
Well, I haven't given you the chance, that's all.
Anyway, let's see. Final check on this diagnostic enters the data here. Alright, the side diagnostic system seems to check out just fine. Alright.
Oh, joy.
With the positronic brain in place, and all the diagnostic systems have just reset. New function. Alright, I'm going to take out... new function, this panel. Now this, here, is the master board. This board basically gives him his personality. There are four different, distinctly different personalities, each on one chip. Now, I have him set for his standard personality, the general all-round Joe Six-Pack guy. Right? So, basically, I'm going to install this, and I'm going to power him up and see what we've got. Right?
This is safe, isn't it? I mean, there's no danger of any...
if there's any danger here... if there's any danger here, it's you, not me. Thing. Alright, like I said, right. So we power up there. What
Oops.
The heck was that? What'd you do? Did you do that?
No. Where that? This flu.
What flu?
Whatever. I don't know.
Yeah, right. You did. It landed over there next to my bionic man. You idiot. Stupid.
Oh!
Just get it out of my way and stay out of my way. Now, as I was saying, you promised me you'd leave my lab stuff alone. When are you going to keep that promise?
Okay, no problem.
You really need to promise. Alright. What the heck is this?
That's interesting.
My son's been in my lab again.
Ah, sure.
He's been selling it beer. Oh, I hope he doesn't see it when he wakes up with a Joe Six-Pack. He has a reason why he's called Joe Six-Pack. He likes to drink Six-Packs all of the time. All right, okay. Wait a minute. Yeah, I broke something. Hold on. Can I get the main board in? My God, I'm taking a long time here. All right. There, now I can get the new function. Alright.
Cool.
Power up.
What?
Alright. Are you ready for the big moment? I have never had this guy running before. The boldly run what no man has run before.
Uh-huh. Sure.
That's very good. Now before I power him up, maybe I should say, this will be the perfect man. He'll be stronger than any man ever born. He'll be smarter than any man ever born. He'll be faster than any man ever born. Pretty much can do everything better than any man ever born. And that's the whole point. He can be a great soldier, great accountant. He can make a great writer, a great scholar. He can do anything, right? Right.
Sure.
So he can even reproduce. Now.
I bet you like that.
I don't. I'm just trying to make the perfect man. I don't have any particularly favorite things to do. I just like to make sure that I'm the first man to do this, okay? This used to be science fiction stuff. All right. So.
I'll believe it when I see it.
Begin powering up. Now, when I hit this switch here.
That switch.
You hear a loud noise for about a few seconds. I hit it again. He will sit up. Hopefully he will have everything intact, he'll have his personality in place and all that. I'll be ready, Mr. Kirk.
May as well, go for it.
That's not supposed to be happening.
I don't think it's working.
Oh, well, there he goes. Finally. Good evening.
Who are you?
What?
Who are you?
I'm Victor von Sessenmeyer.
You? Yeah. Victor von Sessenmeyer. I am Victor von Sessenmeyer.
I am Victor.
You are a secondary imposter.
I'm not.
I am Victor von Sessenmeyer.
Yeah,
I am the scientist.
What's going on?
I have the brain power.
Not turn this
you have
off.
Nothing.
What the heck is going on here? Let me try that again.
You goofed up.
Wait a minute, let me just see. That's not right. The new function. What the heck? Oh, great. I had all the dip switches in the wrong place. That's why it didn't work. I should... There we go. Ah. You see, these dip switches here control the personality, which the,
I mean, hate it when that happens.
Yeah, all right. These dip switches control... How many of you made the perfect man? These dip switches control all the personality, what one is fed into them. Apparently, I accidentally fed in a copy of my personality I had on the computer. That was a mistake.
I'd say.
I shouldn't have...
It's bad enough with one of you were around.
Don't help. There, now it shows the correct personality reading. Yeah. Oops. I made an error. I made another one. There we go. I made another. What the heck is wrong with this thing? Something is not working. I still don't have... I still don't have the dip switches set right over there. No, this one's out of place. Great. New function. I'm never going to get this right. You know that, right? Fine. Get in there! You stupid! There we go. Fine. Now, try again. I'm trying
of your first love.
You try making a perfect man next time you're here. All right. Perfect. Not quite. Hold on. The configuration's a little off. Oh, great. There we go. There. Perfect. Ready to try again?
It better work this time.
I hope it'll work too. You know, this is a project. All right. It's taken an awful long time to sit up because I didn't anticipate.
Must be lazy.
I don't know. I just realized I never gave him a name yet. I have to give him a name. Well, let's find out who he is first.
How about John Doe?
That's stupid. That's Sue. Wait a minute! Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, of course. I'll tell you in a second. Good morning.
Where are my cigarettes?
Cigarettes?
Who took my cigarettes?
I didn't program him to be a smoker.
You got my cigarettes?
I don't have any cigarettes.
You took my cigarettes?
I don't smoke.
Oh.
I don't smoke, and you're not supposed to smoke either. The perfect man ain't supposed to... There's no beer!
Is this supposed to occur?
No! This isn't right. I have to turn him off again, I think.
Where am I?
You're in the lab of Victor von Schlitzenmeier. I created you.
You did?
Yeah, I did.
How come I don't recognize you?
Because you weren't created till now.
Oh, it's gotta be one of those days.
You guess it is. This guy, this guy's even a good comedian, man. Huh? All right. Now, I thought of a name for you. Do you know your name? Of course you don't know your name. You're never given a name, right? I'm going to call you Zaphod.
Zaphod?
Yeah, Zaphod. Your last name will be Beeblebrox. Zaphod Beeblebrox, he was the...
What kind of stupid name is that?
I like it, okay? And you're stuck with it. Zaphod? Here, let me help you up. Whoa!
Oh, sorry.
He's a quick hug. Oh, yeah.
Seems a bit hostile.
He's quite strong. Anyway, Zaphod, I'd like you to meet one of my enemies, friends, Mr. Perry with Cable 10. He's doing a report on you. He was very interested in my creating your.
How you doing?
Not bad. How's yourself?
Be careful now. You gotta remember that you have a lot of...
What's all this stuff here?
Don't touch that. Don't touch that.
What? What?
That's all the stuff I created you with. I mean, it's just... This is all the diagnostic systems. Hey, You're not bad. You see, huh?
I got any gum on you, do
you? Do you have any gum, Mr. Perry?
Negative.
Sorry, no gum, but wait, there's probably some upstairs. We can get you something to eat, maybe. Can I get pizza?
Pizza? Yeah. Sounds good.
We got some pizza upstairs.
Whatever pizza is.
That's great. Well, it looks like he's working. Well, sort of. Not exactly the personality I wanted. He smokes, but nevertheless.
You boast work.
It was terrible.
Well, that's because it's probably stale. I don't even know where those came from.
I'd stock up on them too, sir.
Well, I don't drink beer. My eldest
son. Sure, you don't drink beer.
My eldest son has a friend who, a little kid.
Yeah, friend of a friend of a friend, yeah.
Right. All right. Anyway, I wish it'd be stale. Anyway.
Yeah, this is pretty here.
Hey, well, don't touch that. Don't touch that. It's like, this is, I'm just going to power this lab stuff off. You don't need this stuff now. I'm going to leave the diagnostic board on. That's pretty much it. Now, I want to run you through some tests. Is that all right with you? I'd like to know if you're working properly and all that stuff when you've not hooked to the equipment and all.
Why not?
Sir, now, excuse me. He's got to turn something off.
Cool.
Yeah, it's cool.
I'm alive.
Yeah, he's alive. I brought him to life. I'm always been a good scientist. I always tried to be a good scientist. All right. Set this thing up. All right, power off that light over there. That one.
The hand.
Okay.
Really?
So, the first thing I want to test to see how strong this dude is. So I'm going to go. He's come with us. We're going to be going outside, if that's all right with you.
We are.
Good. Yeah. You've never been outside.
I have not.
It's strange, you know. I thought I'm gonna be loud. Wait a minute, did I turn off the light of the lab there? No, I did not. Could you go turn off the light of the
lab? I guess.
Yes, thank you. But anyway, this van here that you've just seen is low. This is absolutely perfect. There's no way he can have a...
I did it! I turned the light off!
Is that good? Yes, it's very good. He's not a perfect yet. I mean, like, we still need...
Obviously.
He still needs to learn some things. I mean, he's only just arrived. But, I mean, physically, he's perfect. He can't have a heart attack. He can't be killed easily. Well, you know, if you hit him with a nuclear bomb, that'll kill him. But, you know, you can't beat him up. He'd beat you up first. You know,
the delts ain't bad, too, right?
As a matter of fact, I programmed him with some fighting techniques and even the ability to use some high-powered weapons. Remember, he was also supposed to be a soldier. What would you like to be, anyway? A headbanger, perhaps.
What do I want to be? I don't know. What is there to be?
Something definitely weird.
What's this guy do?
He's a reporter.
I'm a reporter.
A reporter. How do you report?
Basically, he just takes this thing around, this camera, and he goes on this thing called a television, and this takes pictures, right? Moving pictures.
I see.
And your voice, it records your voice, and he puts it on this thing.
Do you get to smash things up and blow things up when you're a reporter?
Occasionally, whenever it
He does, yes.
Oh, good.
Yeah, but at least he didn't ruin you. I'm glad of that. I thought he was going to push something and blow up your positronic brain on you.
They ain't over yet.
Oh! All right, let's see if we can get out here. Now, let's go up here. All right. Come on, Zaphod. Now.
Hey, man, what's this?
This is,
this, here.
What's that? Oh, these are dogs! Oh. Yeah, right, these are my pet dogs. This is.
I thought it was his mother.
That's right. This is Scrappy.
Could be.
Kind of she's nervous. Why? Yeah, she.
She?
She, yeah. She, what? Wait now, you don't know what male and female is?
I know what male and female is. It don't look like a she.
Ah!
It looks like a...
Yeah.
Cross between a he and it. Where'd he go? He can't leave me like this.
Alright, and I'll get you to just...
Where are you?
Right here. There's the other dog. He's Tanner.
Hi, other dog.
Tanner. Name is Tanner.
Oh, I smell a strange odor.
Hey.
Tanner.
Aye, yeah. Right. Let's go.
Your mouth don't taste too good, Tanner.
Oh! You're not supposed to eat them. Well, speaking of eating, right, we're supposed to give you something to eat. Right. Forgot about that.
Oh, look at this, cabinets and stuff.
Here it is.
Cool.
Yeah, here, we're gonna get pizza. All right, here, I'm gonna feed him first, because after all, he's never... You don't...
It tastes no good.
You have to get it out of the wrapper first. see? Here's... I forgot about the dogs. Okay. Yeah, here, see? This is called a pizza. Uh-oh. We gotta... Have to cut it first. What's he doing? He must be real hungry. Why don't we cut the pizza? Listen, why don't you shut that thing off and join us for a little snack?
Why not?
Sure, okay. So, are we ready to go here? What was that? Yeah, okay. No problem. What are you... Okay, all right. This way or that? Zaffy.
Zaffy.
We'll call me. All right, all right. Okay, now we're going to take him outside and do some tests. Let's find out what he can do.
I got this far before.
Well, yeah. That was... hold on there. Just shut the door.
Hey, man, this is outside.
Yeah, this is outside,
oh,
man.
Oh, geez, this is great.
That's cool. A lot of wind out here.
Wind.
I hope that wind won't...
Wind. Is that what that is?
Yeah.
Stop blowing.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Okay. Now, I hope that wind won't affect your mic too much, Mr. Perry.
I hope not.
Hey, listen here.
Oh, this is a tool set. What the heck? this door is getting blown shut. Let's just like this.
That's a car over there.
It is.
Yeah, an automobile, yeah.
Cool.
Yeah,
hey, what's this thing here?
That's a tree.
It is.
Hey, can you climb that? You don't eat it. I guess you can't climb. Well, don't climb that tree. It's too weak.
Well, you can climb
heavy.
Anything.
He's 245 pounds.
What we got here?
What? Oh, this is
water.
Yeah.
Water.
This is
water.
This is
weird.
It's a stream. Oh,
stream. Right.
So, yeah. Hold that thing down.
Oh, hey. What's all this stuff here?
This is
air.
Yeah.
Air. Is that what that is? Oh.
No, that's the barn.
What
the heck?
That's a beard.
Put that on your face.
That's a beard. That's my glasses. Hey, I can't see without my glasses. Where are... Whoa. Oh.
This ain't no good.
Well, that's because I got bad eyes, so you're designed to be perfect.
Oh, okay.
You've got perfect eyes, but I don't. What are you doing? You're not supposed to eat everything.
This all stuff right. Ain't no good.
Anyway, well... Now what's he doing?
What's that?
It's a tractor.
Oh.
You use this to mow your lawn. You see, you get into this.
What's
here.
Lawn?
That right there, the green stuff.
Oh, that's lawn, eh?
Yeah. You see, it grows.
I wouldn't recommend,
Anyway, that's what this thing is for. It's for mowing your lawn. You sit in this, you steer it with this, you tell it which way to go to this, and you turn it on, and you can... Ah, it's wet! The sea is wet! Ah! Oh!
Oh, that's that water stuff from over there, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, it's cold! Anyway, I've forgotten that seat with my... Don't! You're gonna poison yourself!
Oh, some sandpaper.
Anyway, Mr. Perry. First of all, this guy is supposed to be... He has two basic abilities. So, basically, he can make you a perfect mathematician, basically, you know?
Prove it.
Well... That's the square root of 256. Alright, and of course you can do simple math. 3 plus 4 is?
7.
Yeah, good one. Good one, very, very good. Now, you see?
Not bad for first go at it.
Yeah, well, it's just the fact that he's never been put in a classroom is what's amazing, see? 3 plus 4, I mean, anybody can figure that out, but except for one thing. He's only just been alive for a few of, 20 minutes.
We'll give a guy a chance.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. And look, remember what I was saying? He's back up a little here for me. Get right about there. Now, why don't you... sorry, it's not your fault. He can't back up.
Oh.
All right about there.
Hey, what's that up there?
That's the sky. That's the sun
there.
Hey,
that's great.
That's called the sun. You're okay?
Yep, okay.
All right. Now, basically, he's also very, very strong physically. Now, first... Oh, yeah, I forgot one test. Here, come over here. Stand here. Put your arm up like that.
Like this here?
Yeah. Now try to push my arm that way.
Oh, okay.
Right. See?
Hey, is that supposed to happen?
Yeah, it's supposed to happen.
Apparently.
That was quite strong, and then there was something else he can do too. Watch this.
I guess I'm supposed to.
He's not only physically strong, but he can also take a lot of punishment. See?
What are you doing that for?
He's
I didn't do nothing.
I know you didn't do nothing. I'm trying to test your strength. They're not gonna hurt you any.
I mean, you can't be hurt by this. I mean, look. I mean, how much is that gonna hurt now?
Cut it out.
Well, it's not gonna hurt you any. Look, it's just...
I don't recommend that course of action.
Look. Don't.
He's programmed to have a perfectly mild disposition. Perfectly safe. I mean, you see, that's it. He never gets into a fight unless he has to. He knows I can't hurt him. Right? So he's not gonna have any problem. See?
No problem, no.
My glasses! My beard!
What's all this red stuff, eh?
What?
It's
Jesus!
Cool, eh?
What happened?
Hey, you with the camera! This is cool, man! Look at it! Hi! Look at this! Something else I found! See? Look, you got it too! Look! Ha ha! Cool! Hey, you want to see?
Stay back, buddy.
Oh, sorry.
Zaphod!
Yeah.
What? That's blood.
Blood, eh? Tastes like copper.
Yes, it does.
Not bad.
It's my blood.
We live on it.
You're not supposed to beat people up. I mean, I was only testing you. It's not like I could have hurt you. You're supposed to have a subroutine that keeps you from beating people up when you know they're not a danger to you. What happened to you?
Beating people up.
Yeah,
but I'm supposed to beat people up, aren't I?
Obviously, there's something wrong with this program.
I asked you before. Did I get to beat people up and stuff?
Not yet. I'm still not creating. Creating you.
Huh.
Whoa.
Hey, look at that.
Let's see. What? Go away, you created. Go away. Go.
No, no. Let me see.
What? Okay, easy. Go. That part. You've already made enough mess in you. Apparently, I'd like to take you down to the lab and see if I can make some repairs.
Not now. I like it out here.
All right, come on.
This is nice.
Come on.
Hey, what's that over there?
Jesus.
Whoa, cool.
It's a motor vehicle.
Wow. We gotta get this guy down to the lab. But I gotta get to a mirror. What the heck
has
he done to me?
Is it
very bad?
I
think that's cool. Isn't that nice the way that trickles out? Right, picturesque, eh? It's just like a stream over there, eh? Except it's red instead, you know?
Well,
what's wrong?
To reprogram this.
Why is he mad at me?
Another one of the personalities.
What do I do? Why is he mad at me?
Mr. Sletzenminer.
He really smashed my face.
Mr. Sletzenminer.
What are you trying to do to my face? I'm sorry. I gotta see this.
What? What's he mad about?
I think you hurt him slightly.
Hurt him? Don't be foolish.
Remember that pain you were talking about before?
I'm experiencing a lot of it now. Lab now.
Lab. Ow. I just don't know why he's mad, that's all.
I'm angry. Same reason you were angry, I guess.
Angry.
Not pretty, is it, Doug? Is it safe to come in here?
It is now. I powered him off.
How did you manage that?
Well, he didn't know I was doing it, you see. Remember, he didn't know any of this stuff was for, so I just had to push the right button.
I don't think you know what any of this stuff is for.
I know what it's all for, and I built him, didn't I?
Does it work? No.
Alright, I'm going to change boards here, new function. I'm going to go back to the diagnostic board and make a check. Oh, what the heck?
Did you find out what is wrong?
No, that's what I'm trying to find out now. That's why I'm putting in the diagnostic board. It could be an overload in the positronic brain. It could be almost anything.
Why didn't I didn't think of that?
Well, because you didn't build him. Yep. All right. I'm ready for diagnostic. Let's see.
What's the switch? That's no fun.
Hold on there.
Hmm?
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Right. Alright.
Okay.
I can't seem to find anything wrong. It must be a programming error. Well,
I like
just
that.
To be absolutely sure, I'm going to give him a physical inspection and see if maybe
there
might be something
that's a good idea.
But,
Maybe I can help. Yeah.
What the?
Don't turn it on!
Uh-oh.
It's the diagnostic board was in here!
I think we have a problem! A problem!
I'm dead!
Oh, Jesus! Somebody do something! No! Oh. No! No!
I hope you are satisfied.
What happened to him?
Do you remember this?
Unfortunately, yeah.
I remember I blasted you with it once. It wasn't working properly then. Of course it has to be working properly now. Take a look here. What we got? Looks like his positronic brain is seriously damaged.
It's not moving.
Of course he's not moving. I had to shoot him with the phaser.
Yeah, but it didn't work before. After all, I'm still here.
I hope it didn't work properly. But, I think you broke a promise, didn't you?
I don't recall making any such promise.
Yes, you did. You promised you wouldn't touch anything in the lab, not one blessed thing. And as it turns out, Mr. Perry, you, pushed a rather critical switch, you know?
That switch over there?
Switch over there.
Little teeny tiny switch.
Yeah, the little teeny tiny switch. You know, you turned him on and he didn't even have a personality. He just went nuts. Now I'm going to miss him. He was a nice dude.
Aw, isn't that real nice?
You know what else is real nice?
No.
I'm not generally a violent man.
However.
Exactly. That will not remain the case this time.